going to wipe this. So I can give you a clear picture of what is happening. Okay? Praise the Lord. Give a big hand to Jesus. Okay. We'll break it up, eh? That's the rapture. That's chapter 19. This is the 7 years of tribulation. Halfway is 3.5 years, and another 3.5 years. This is chapter 4. Chapter 4, John is taken up to heaven. Come up here. The voice of a trumpet. He's taken up here. Then he sees the throne room of God. And you read through chapter 4 and chapter 5. There is no one to open the seals. He's seven. All of a sudden, someone touches him and said, there is one worthy to open the seals. Then as you look, there was one. As a lamb that was slain, he was worthy to open the seals. So the seals are being opened. He's up here, chapter 4 and chapter 5. Then from here, the seals begin to be opened. Okay, so let me put it here. Seals open. Open. At the same time, when the church is taken away, the Antichrist cannot step into the scene until the church is taken away. He can only step into, he is there in the, right now in moving up the ranks. But you will recognize him like I shared yesterday on concerning the Antichrist. Soon as the church is taken, he steps into the scene. According to 2 Thessalonians, he cannot move in until something is taken away. So as soon as the church is gone, he appears. What happens? He makes a covenant with Israel for 7 years. Makes a covenant. He's going to make the peace in the Middle East. He comes as a conqueror to make peace. Not only that, the temple of the Jews, or the temple of Israel, will be rebuilt. Everything is set. Actually, I was talking with Pastor Egi, the work has already begun. The foundation is being laid right now as we speak. So the temple will be in place, the sacrifices will begin. In the middle here, he is wounded. In the heavenly realm, something is happening. The dragon, which I shared with us yesterday, the accuser of the brethren is cast down from heaven. No more he can stand before the throne room of God. He knows his time is short. He comes down with great wrath, anger. The dragon, when he comes down, the Antichrist is wounded. He will give all authority and power to the Antichrist. He will rise up from the wound, heal completely to counterfeit Christ. What he does, when he rises up here, he deals with the two witnesses. The two witnesses, their ministry begins right here. Their ministry is for 42 months, 1,260 days. Their ministry. Then all of a sudden, halfway, the ministry is fulfilled. They are lying on the streets of Jerusalem. They are killed. And then they go up to heaven. They are taken up. So we have a clear idea what is happening. In heaven, the seals are being opened. Chapter 4, chapter 5, he sees the throne room of God. He sees the Lamb is worthy. Then the Lamb opened the seals. As the seals have been opened, these two men stand here, part of their ministry. The ministry lasts for 3.5 years. We have read they have the ability to call upon all the plagues in your Bible as often as possible. They can turn the water into blood and every other drinking vessel that has water into blood. They can shut the heavens, which we read from Luke. When the heavens is shut, what happened? Famine happens. When the water is turned to blood and fishes die, stink, and all this kind of thing, guess what happened? Sickness comes. So these two men have the ability to call it. At the same time, the seals are being opened in heaven. Now listen carefully what I'm going to say. When they speak on earth, the seal is open in heaven. Destruction. Praise the Lord. And I have opened part of it because I want us to go back to the opening of the seals, and we're going to see that it links together with Revelation 11, their ability to speak. They torment the whole earth. Why? Because they're revealing sin. When the church, you and I, are not able to confront the world powers concerning sin, these two men will do it. Idol worship, they're going to deal with it. All this Islam and Hinduism and Shintoism, Buddhism, all the ism, they're going to deal with it. Praise the Lord. These two fearless. The same spirit is in them, is in us. Hallelujah. Amen. Same spirit. Just that we are not getting it done. In your village, in your home, you've got to confront it. You've got to deal with sin. The Spirit of the Lord is in you. He's going to deal with sin because he hates it. Praise the Lord. Let's go to chapter 6. The seals are being opened. And we'll see the operation happening in heaven, fulfilled on earth. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. As they speak on earth, whatsoever we bound on earth is bound in heaven. Whatsoever we loose on earth is loosed in heaven. They hold their authority. Let's go to chapter 6. And I saw when the Lamb opened one of the seals, and I heard as it were the noise of thunder, one of the four beasts say, come and see. And I saw it, behold, a white horse. It's coming in. It's happening. And he that sat on him had a bow. And the crown was given unto him. That means he came in as a king. And he went forth conquering and to conquer. And I explained that to us concerning the work of the Antichrist. He comes in very subtly to bring peace, to make this covenant with Israel. But he's coming to conquer. And you find that when he steps into the scene, he topples three. Yeah? I shared yesterday, three horns he toppled. Three kings. And these horns start to speak loudly and speak great, so he's taking total authority. Verse 3, the second seal is being opened. When he opened the second seal, I heard the second beast say, come and see. There went out another horse that was red. And power was given to him that sat thereon to take peace from the earth. So when this second horseman came in, he bring in more war. And that they should kill one another, there was given unto him a great sword. So as this thing is happening all around the world, there is more war is happening. He secures this covenant with Israel. He tries to bring in that peace with Islam and Zion, Israel. So he secures it so they can rebuild the temple. But at the same time, son against father. Nation against nation is rising up. Wars. You remember what I shared with you? Yesterday, the Antichrist, he doesn't respect any God, but he honors the God of forces. What does he do? He gives gift. God of forces, the God of fortresses. He does not worship that God, but he makes a deal with them. So the violence you see now is not going to go down. It will escalate more. The terrorism that we see now will escalate more. We've never seen anything yet. This Antichrist will come in so subtly, somehow he'll be able to secure something that he will speak and he will be able to solve problem here, problem there, and the people will sway and turn around to him to follow him. This Antichrist. The whole world is peace. The whole world is talking about human rights. Just today I was watching, refugees coming out of Syria, coming out and going into Hungary. Now they build the wall there. Now they fence the whole place. Cannot come in anymore. And they're just lying down in certain places. And one of the German journalists was speaking concerning the human rights. This Antichrist, he will very subtly can balance everything together in his ability to hold everything together. Because he will be given the cunningness and the deceivingness of the devil will be in him to find the answer for the world. So the whole world will sway. Oh, he's the man. He will fight for human rights, he will fight for animal rights, he will fight for all kind of rights. Not only that, he'll try to get the peace with Israel to make the covenant. So when this red horse comes in, there is more wars. More is happening. But the Antichrist is also in. Verse 5, third horseman. When he had opened the third seal, I heard the third beast say, come and see. And I beheld a lower black horse, and he that sat on me had a pair of balances in his hand. And I heard a voice in the midst of the four beasts say, a measure of wheat for a penny, and three measures of barley for a penny, and see thou heard not the oil and the wine. What has happened is this, the food has gone down, famine has happened. Every time you have war, you must have famine. After the Second World War, great famine. Look at the wars happening in Africa. As soon as they finish, they win. Famine, no food. Food is destroyed. So famine is coming in. At the same time that the wars is coming, famine is following. Your food prices are not going to get low anymore. Your loaf of bread that used to be 50 cents will continue to rise up. Asking in Rutuma is $1.50. One loaf of bread. It will rise up, everything rising up. A pack of tobacco in Rutuma is $6 for a pack of 10. And it's flying. Hot cake. Nothing is going to go down. Everything will go up. That is the reason why we need to totally lean on him. It doesn't stop here. Actually, I like to watch Al Jazeera, you know, and I have that time, I own it, because it goes world. Just the other day, I opened it, they were talking on China, how China is being built up, how China have to deal with the economy, their employment, at the same time, don't destroy the green, the forests. So it was on today, so they mark it, so everything balanced. So if you're going to build a city or build a anything, they make sure that you don't pollute the place, because very much into climate change. And then when I was watching, they talk about the food. How are they going to feed 1.3 billion people? So I tell you, the food, everything is getting higher. So China have to try to look every way for the agriculture to feed 1.3 billion people. And I was looking at it, I said, man, when this horsemen come in, we're going to really cry and the price of food is going to go up. And in that famine and in that time there, when the Antichrist is going to put his law, you cannot trade, you cannot sell, nor can you buy, unless you have the money. So it's all going to corner us in one place. Verse 7, when he had opened the fourth seal, I heard the voice of the fourth beast saying, come and see. And I looked and behold a pale horse. And his name that sat on him was Death. And hell followed with him. And power was given unto him over the fourth part of the earth. So one quarter of the earth, he had the power to do something. What was it? To kill with the sword, with hunger. Like I said, when war happened, famine happened, there is hunger. And with death, and with the beasts of the earth. All of a sudden, some place is going to go away. Some of the beasts of death will kill men. Things are not going to be in control. Things will go chaos when this fourth horseman is released. Sickness will be present. Let's look at verse 9. When he had opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar, I already touched this yesterday, because it's in line with chapter 9 of the book of Revelation. And we'll skip that, because it deals of those whose soul they have come from tribulation. Okay, let me read it again. When he had opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of them that were slain for the word of God and for the testimony which they held. And they cried with a loud voice, saying, how long, O Lord, holy and true, dost thou not judge and avenge our blood on them that dwell on the earth? And the white robes were given unto every one of them, and it was said unto them that they should rest yet for a little season, until their fellow servants also and their brethren that should be killed as they were should be fulfilled. So here were certain saints, they are killed and they have died. Where? Here. And they are calling for justice, but God tells them, wait for a while for your other brethren to come. Okay, verse 4. Let's touch the sixth seal. When it opened the sixth seal, and lo, there was a great earthquake. And the sun became black as sackcloth of hair, and the moon became as blood. There was a great earthquake. What is happening? In your Bible, did anyone speak an earthquake came? Can you remember? There's a rebellion. Korah. Rebellion against Moses. Said, separate yourselves. They come with their incense. All of a sudden Moses speak, and the earth opens. Big earthquake happens. They fall in. These two men have the power, praise the Lord, to speak and it happened. So as they speak here on earth, the seals are open. As they speak, famine is coming. As they speak, everything is happening. As they speak, earthquake happened. And lo, there was a great earthquake, and the sun became black as sackcloth. So some just that day decide not to just turn up black. They have the power to do it. The same way Moses spoke, and that day no sun came out. And the moon became as blood. Some few months ago, we were in Utuma, everybody, hey, the moon is red. Everybody had quit. Many was coming to me. Tatala, what's the meaning of this? And I said, that's the preview. Don't try to theologize this thing. It is as he said here. Verse 13. And the stars of heaven fell unto the earth, even as a fig tree casteth her untimely figs when she is shaken of a mighty wind. Stars fall, what happened? Things that the scientists are afraid of. Some of these things are going to fall from heaven. These meteors that we, I tell you, the scripture says, they're going to fall. It's going to come. Verse 14, and the heaven departed as a scroll. When it is rolled together. And every mountain and island were moved out of their places. All of a sudden, Rutuma there, get Sokas gang in the equator again. How did we move there? I don't know. All the plates move. The whole earth is moving. These things fall from heaven.
It's for a reason. And the reason is in verse 15. Look at verse 15 properly.
And the kings of the earth, and the great men, and the rich men, and the chief captains, and the mighty men, and every bondman, and every free man, hid themselves in the dens, and in the rock of the mountains, and said to the mountains and rocks, fall on us, and hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne, and from the wrath of the Lamb. For the great day of his wrath is come, and who shall be able to stand? We've never seen anything yet. We've never seen anything yet. These 7 years of tribulation, the wrath of the Lamb will be seen. That is why the church is not appointed to wrath, but to salvation. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Do not grieve the Spirit, the Holy Spirit of promise, for you have been sealed until the day of redemption. Here, redemption you got. Redemption, buyback, salvation complete. Body, soul, and spirit complete in the rapture. Church, go. We will not stay for these 7 years. If you do, then you have been unfaithful in your walk. The church of Thyatira says, repent. Otherwise, you're going to throw us in with Jezebel on the bed, commit adultery with that sister, and enter into tribulation the great. That's why our walk must be separate from God. Cannot go into the system of adultery. Idolatry and adultery with Jezebel. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
We'll skip chapter 7 because we'll come back to that later. It's talking about 144,000. I already give us some brief understanding there. We'll skip the question that Seru gave that day, verse 9 onward. But we come to chapter 8, because the seals, I want to continue with the seals. The seals are being opened. Chapter 8, verse 1. And when he had opened the seventh seal, there was silence in heaven about the space of half an hour. Silence. Everybody. You know, like when you honor someone who died, great men of the government or the chief, everybody just, let's be silent for a minute. Sometimes they have it in the rugby. One of the good rugby players died and everybody stays silent for 2 minutes in the ground. Heaven is half an hour because something will happen on earth. Verse 2, and I saw the seven angels which stood before God, and to them were given seven trumpets. The seals are open. Trumpet now, judgment is coming. And another angel came and stood at the altar having a golden censer. And there was given unto him much incense that he should offer it with the prayer of all saints upon the golden altar which was before the throne. And the smoke of the incense which came from the prayer of the saints ascended up before God out of the angel's hand. And the angel took the censer and filled it with fire of the altar and cast it into the earth. There were voices or noises and thunderings and lightnings and an earthquake. Now you see what's happening in heaven. There is a censer representing the prayer of the saints. There is crying out from earth. There are those who are under the altar crying out. Then he takes all those prayers, receive it, the incense. He puts fire there into this censer, and he throws it down to the earth. Judgment is happening. The prayers are being fulfilled. The cry for justice is coming to pass. Verse 6. And the seven angels which had the seven trumpets prepared themselves to sound. This is in heaven. It's still here in this first part. It's still going on. And the seven, verse 7 is the first trumpet. And the first angel sounded. There followed hail and fire mingled with blood. They were cast upon the earth, and the third part of the trees was burnt up, and all green grass was burnt up. One third, this thing happened. Guess who's speaking? is to. They prophesy, hail, just like in the time of Moses. Only in Egypt. These two global. They speak and it happened. Hail, mingled with fire and blood is cast down. And the third part of the trees was burnt up. Tell me, the climate change, what is happening? Well, judgment is coming. Earth is also being judged. In this sense, for man has turned to Mother Earth for his solution and not to God. That's why everything that's happening today is all climate change, climate change, climate change, climate change. You want to build a house, you must agree to the climate change. Before, OHS. Now, OHS plus climate change. Everything. Climate change. Because they're looking to Earth as their solution. If we honor Earth, if we treasure Earth, she will look after us. Today I said I was watching the TV on China. They quote from some of the old men of industrial, great men, some 20, 50 years ago. And one of them quoted and said, whatever we give, it will come back to us. So they were honoring the Mother Earth. And I was looking, I said, okay. Let's see what happened when these two men step into ministry. You can try. The Lech and Rutuman can do everything they want to do. But this will come to pass. Okay, so your first trumpet, one third of the vegetation is gone. One third of the trees is gone. One third of the grass is burnt up. Green grass. Where did it fall? I don't know. It fell. Maybe in which continent? I don't really know. Only know one third. The second angel. The second angel sounded, and it was a great mountain, as it were, great mountain, burning with fire, was cast into the sea. Then the third part of the sea became blood. I don't know. It's a volcano. I don't know how, but this mountain just fall in the sea, and the sea turn into blood. It might be a star, it might be a meteor, I don't know what it is, but it's a great mountain. Great mountain must be as big as Fiji. Boo! She became blood. Verse 9, and the third part of the creatures which were in the sea and had life died. And the third part of the ships were destroyed. So at this time, don't hang around in the sea at this time. If you're still around. Third part of the creature, all the whales, the fish, the dolphin, they all die. When they die, the whole sea will turn to blood.
Stink.
It will stink. Sickness will come. All these big ships, warships, containers, one third of them destroyed. Let's look to the third trumpet. Now I want to tell you something. This is literally going to happen. It's not something like symbolic and we try to theologize it. Oh, you know, this mountain might be, he's speaking spiritual mountain. Must be a spiritual mountain. It's not a spiritual mountain, it's a real mountain.
Amen.
Verse 10, the third trumpet. These two speaking from earth. See, everything that is in your Old Testament, they can perform it in the book of Revelation globally. Praise the Lord. And the third angel, and the name of the, verse 10. And the third angel sounded, and there fell a great star from heaven. Burning. Great star from heaven, burning as it were a lamp. So now you got the picture of the meteor, whatever you call it. It's coming. And it fell upon the third part of the rivers and upon the fountains of waters. There goes your Fiji water. And the name of the star is called Wormwood. And the third part of the waters became Wormwood. And many men died of the waters because they were made bitter. Like they were poisoned. You couldn't drink it. It was poison. It's like some kind of biological warfare. But it's a star, okay? It's a star came from heaven and destroyed one third of the waters. Okay, so one third of the waters is turned to blood. This one third is turned to bitterness. So you only have one third left. So this, it's bitter. I tell you, you will see this thing in some of your cartoons that's going on. You know, they have rollers type and everybody can't drink. Because they try to explain when the church goes, they have nothing to explain. They're alien. The UFOs. Pastor Samson is gone. He don't respect me. Okay, verse 12. The fourth trumpet. And the fourth angel sounded, and the third part of the sun was smitten, and the third part of the moon, and the third part of the stars. So as the third part of them was darkened, and the day shone not for a third part of it, and the night likewise. So the 12 hours of daylight that we have, it's going to be cut down. Cut down by 4 hours. Well, 3 is 12. So we only have 8 hours. The sun, something happened to the sun. It can't fulfill its journey. I don't know what happened to it. But it'll be cut off. Even the moon cannot finish its journey. Every day. Verse 13, and I beheld and heard an angel flying through the midst of the heavens, saying with a loud voice, woe, woe, woe to the inhabitants of the earth, by reason of the other voices of the trumpet of the three angels which are yet to sound. Three more left. Chapter 9. And the fifth angel sounded his trumpet. And I saw a star fall from heaven unto the earth. And to him was given the key of the bottomless pit. So this star might be the other star or star angel, we don't know. And he opened the bottomless pit, and there arose a smoke out of the pit. And as the smoke of a great furnace, and the sun and the air were darkened by reason of the smoke of the pit. So I tell you, this big pit just opened, and even the sun is blocked by the smoke that is coming out of this pit. You've never seen anything, and it's from the earth. Might be a big volcano just opened up, we don't know. But all the sun is blocked with all these ashes and all these things there in the air. Verse 3, and there came out of the smoke locusts. So out of this thing came out locusts upon the earth. Unto them was given power. So they have some power. They're not normal locusts. This locust got power. As the scorpions of the earth have power. So they have this kind of power like the scorpion. And it was commanded them that they should not hurt the grass of the earth. Now one third of your grass is already gone, eh? They should not hurt the grass of the earth, neither any green thing, okay, it's hell, neither any tree, but only those men which have not the seal of God in their foreheads. There is one seal, 666, there is another one, the saints. So when these locusts come, they will not hurt the vegetation. They only go for men. Them who do not have the seal of God. And to them it was given that they should not kill them, but that they should be tormented 5 months. They tormented this earth, these two men. Well, they hate these two. Because when these two speak, things begin to happen. And their torment was as the torment of a scorpion when he striketh a man. So we don't have scorpion here. But if you've been bitten by the centipede, at least you'll know a little bit of it. It's about 5% of scorpion. Verse 6, and in those days shall men seek death. So see what God has done here. Has allowed to happen. Those days shall men seek death and shall not find it. They shall desire to die, and death shall flee from them. All of a sudden, God just blocked the angel of death. They'll want to die. How? They're going to injection or what, but they can't die. Do you know that's the desire of people today? I don't want to die.
And they want to live forever when they have 100, 200 years.
Well, look forward to this day. This time you can't die, but in much pain. And the ships of the locusts was like unto horses, prepared unto battle. That means they all stand in ranks. And on their heads were as it were crowned like gold, and their faces were as the faces of men. This is how these locusts look like. Their hair as the hair of women. So look at hair. And their teeth were as the teeth of lions. These are different kind of locusts. They had breastplates. They're like a military. And it were breastplates of iron, and the sound of their wings was as the sound of chariots of many horses running to battle. They had tails like unto scorpions. There were stings in their tails, and their power was to hurt men 5 months. They had a king over them, which is the angel of the bottomless pit, whose name in the Hebrew tongue is Abaddon, but in the Greek tongue had his name Apollyon. One woe is past, and behold, there come two woes more hereafter. These locusts are demonic inspired. They come from this angel, from this pit. They have demonic ability. That's why they're able to sting, but you can die. God has withheld death to come. And it happens here. This is not something that we try to dream or some form of army or military. No, no, no. According to the scripture, all of this will come out of the bottomless pit. As this great star hit this earth, this hole is open and they come out and they are there to torment men. You know, just like that torment, that man that was in that place, that was with heat, thirsty, and he turned around and he saw Father Abraham and he said, Father Abraham, can you tell Lazarus to dip his finger in water and put in my mouth? For where I am in great torment and great heat and thirst. Abraham said, there is a separation. We cannot cross over, nor can you cross over. And he said, I have 5 brothers in this earth still alive. Can you send one from the dead, from where you are, to my 5 brothers who is alive, to inform them that this place is real? So he's there, he can't die, this guy. He's forever under torment. And Abraham said, they have Moses and the prophet, Jebediah. Even if we should send one from the dead, if they don't believe Moses and the prophets, they will not believe that person. Because the way of salvation is by his word. Moses and prophets testify of Christ, his suffering, and the glory he is to stand in. So here we have this thing happening. Okay, let's go on to verse 14. Now the sixth angel, which had the trumpet, loosed the 4 angels which are bound in the great river Euphrates. And the 4 angels were loosed which were prepared. These 4 angels have been kept for such a time like this. All these thousands of years, they have been kept. This is their ministry. They were prepared for an hour, a day, and a month, and a year for to slay 1/3 of men. So the first group, the locusts came, men can't die. They are in great pain, a great torment. They can't die. Now comes these 4 angels. And we come to verse 16. And the number of the army of the horsemen were 200,000, and I heard the number of them. Thus I saw the horses in the vision, and them that sat on them having breastplates of fire, and of jacinth and brimstone. And the heads of the horses was as the heads of lions, and out of their mouth issued fire and smoke and brimstone. By these 3 were the 1/3 of men killed, by the fire, by the smoke, and by the brimstone, which issued out of their mouth. You try and figure that out. Fire, brimstone, maybe nuclear, we don't know. They have the ability and they destroy 1/3 of men killed. For their power is in their mouth and in their tails, for their tails were like unto serpents and had heads, and with them they do hurt. And the rest of the men which were not killed by these plagues, so 2/3 of men left, billion people left, 2/3. And the rest of the men which were not killed by this plague, yet repented not of the works of their hands. They reveal sin, they speak out, the plagues happen, things happen on earth, men never repent. The same way Egypt, Pharaoh never repented. This is what happened to earth. The purpose of prophecy is to reveal sin for men to turn back to God. That is the purpose. So we go to verse 20. And the rest of the men which were not killed by these plagues, see it's written here plagues, eh? Plagues connect with these men who can make plagues as much as they want, as often as they want. Were not killed by these plagues, yet repented not of the works of their hands, that they should not worship devils. So they were worshipping devils. Devil worship is right here. You know your horoscope? This is a big thing right now. Zodiac, horoscope, this is all devil worship. Today everybody is going to watch all those people who can read palm and they take one something, one pen belonging to you and you give it to them and they can try to, like, they can tell you whatever. And also the tarot cards, all these things is very much alive now. Mark my word, not very long we'll have it in Hibiscus. There will be a booth there. You can read palm. I never go to this Hibiscus, but maybe it's already there. But I went to flea market some years ago. It's there in the flea market. I don't know, still present or not. Men did not repent of devil worship. Some years ago, when I was in Nandera, I was going out of our home and we were staying there. It's early morning, about 6:30 or 6 o'clock. I saw my neighbor. Nearby. Because we have seen it often, for so many years we have accepted it. But then I went to Rutuma, so we don't see it in Rutuma. Then I come back, then I saw it. So I walk slowly and I watch him. He took all these flowers. He took something like this to the sun, and morning sun, and breaking the flowers in. Then he came to his stone. There was one stone in his compound. And he bowed down and he was doing all that and I looked at him. I went, I came back, I told my wife, you know what is happening? In our midst, we've accepted it. Demonic worship. Devil worship is right here in our midst. The worship of Krishna and Hanuman and Vishnu and who else is right here. And the church will keep the mouth shut. We just wait for Diwali. We can also go and taste the luxury. The church, these two men, they speak against it. They prophesy against it. When earth never listened, they speak. And heaven listened, and all these plagues come down. As often as they would like to, they spoke and had the ability to do it. Now the Bible says in verse 20, yet repented not of the works of the hands. What happened to the works? The works of the hand is corrupt. The works of the hand is not clean before God. Which means there's a lot of corruption. There's a lot of bad deeds done. And they did not repent of it. The psalmist said this word. Who can go up to Mount Zion? Only then have a pure heart and clean hands. Well, the world didn't have clean hands. They repented not of the works of their hands, number one. That they should not worship devils and idols of gold and silver and brass and stone and wood, which neither can see nor hear nor walk. Men never repented. Idols are coming in real quick. Worship of nature, wood, they're worshiping trees. Nature is the answer for us. The answer.
nature is now being judged by God. Anything that you put before God shall be judged by God. So don't put your family before God. You're going to get in the way. What God wants to bless your family. Your family must be number two. God must be number one. Don't put your husband number one. And God number two. He stand in the place of God. Praise the Lord. Know your vision. Know your mission. Know your calling. Know your ministry. It must come second to God. So they did not repent. Verse 21. I'm going to close here. Because the other one is the veil judgments we will touch later. Neither repented they of their murders. They were murders. There was killing happening. Murdering happened. What is happening now? Violence is happening. Terrorism is happening. They never repent of it. Not only that, nor of their sorcery. Okay, let me take that word sorcery because it is a different word from the word sorcery meaning magic. Yeah? When we hear the word sorcery, we think of magic. We think of those movies used to come. I forgot what's the name of that sorcerer. You know it. Merlin. So when we